Hello, neighbors. I'm Heather Kolich, your University of Georgia Extension contact in Forsyth County for questions about agriculture and natural resources. We have two other program areas in Extension, Family and Consumer Sciences and 4-H Youth Leadership Development. Extension is the educational outreach branch of the University of Georgia. We're here to provide you with research-based, unbiased answers to your questions. We're here in the Learning for Life Garden today to answer your questions about that dreaded tomato disease, blossom end rot. Yep, blossom end rot is exactly what it sounds like. At the end of the tomato, where the blossom was attached, the tomato begins to rot. This blossom end rot can affect other plants too, including watermelons and peppers. Many callers ask me, what can I spray to help solve this problem? Well, there is no magic spray. Cultural conditions cause blossom end rot. You can change the conditions. That won't heal tomatoes that already have the disease, but it can help other tomatoes that are still growing. It can keep them from getting the disease. The two conditions that cause blossom end rot are uneven watering and insufficient calcium in the soil. To address the uneven watering, we need to try and maintain a constant level of moisture in the soil. It's the fluctuations in moisture that keep the plant from moving calcium throughout all of its parts. Tomatoes need 1 to 1.5 inches of water each week to maintain healthy growth. Here at the Learning for Life Garden, we use drip irrigation that puts the moisture right down on the soil where it needs to be. Adding 2 to 4 inches of mulch over the soil helps keep the soil from drying out too quickly. Mulch is also an excellent weed suppressant. To address the calcium deficiency issue, we're going to add calcium to the soil with a technique called side dressing. You can add calcium either with agricultural gypsum or with typical lawn lime. That's what I have here today, just the kind of lime that you would put on your lawn in the summer. To go to work, the calcium needs to be in contact with the soil. So the first thing we're going to do is pull back the mulch from the area. Then we're going to sprinkle the calcium, the lime, onto the soil about 4 to 6 inches away from the plants. We'll just treat all of these plants here. Just sprinkle it down in there. And then I'm going to cover it back up with the mulch. And water it in. This side dressing technique is also an excellent way to get fertilizer into your garden plants. Tomatoes are heavy feeders, and they'll need an additional application of nitrogen every 4 to 6 weeks. But don't over-fertilize. If you have lots and lots of lush green leaves, but no blossoms and no fruit, you're probably over-loving that plant with too much nitrogen. Here's a bonus tip. Pick your tomatoes as soon as they begin to blush. They'll be just as tasty if they ripen on your counter as they will if they ripen on the vine. But picking early gives you two perks. First, it encourages your tomato plant to create more flowers, which means you'll get more fruit. Second, it helps you control pests in your garden. Ripening fruit lures insects to come into the garden. These are the insects that want to eat your produce before you get a chance to do it. So picking early will also help you control pests in your garden. I hope this helps. Remember, if you have questions, Extension has answers. Thank you for your time and happy gardening.